Today I'm in the Montebello area in Quebec. I've been invited by Subaru Canada to try out the new Subaru Forester Premier and Wilderness. The Forester has been redesigned for 2022. So a few changes in the front bumper, the lights, the grille, also in the back. Mostly a mid-cycle refresh. That's all we call that in the automotive world. But the big story here today, and this is the model I'm driving right now. It's the new Wilderness trim level. So just like the Subaru Outback Wilderness I drove previously this summer, they're adding this trim level also to the Forester. It's pretty cool. The Wilderness trim level is not the most expensive trim level. It's just underneath the Premier and the Limited model. So it's an off-road model. It's more capable. It's been lifted a little bit, you know, suspension is tuned to do some off-roading, more rugged roads, I could say. You've got all-terrain tires. You got also more clearance in the front and also in the back. Especially here in Canada, we've got some big skid plates underneath this Wilderness Forester, protecting the underneath of the engine and also the differential in the back. There's a big difference between the Canadian models and the US model. The skid plates are way bigger on the Canadian model, so that's a big plus for the Canadian market. Otherwise, we've got some rugged big plastic bumper in the front and also in the back. We've got some fog lights, we've got some matte details on the hood, we've got some bronze finish, you know, pieces all around the exterior. We've got a big roof rack. You can put up to 800 pounds one your park, I could say, not while, you know, driving, but still, if you do some camping, overlanding and all that, that's a lot of weight. 800 pounds for this, you know, type of car, this size of car, that's pretty cool. Also, the gearing in the Wilderness, it's a little bit shorter, so you know, it's a little bit quicker off the line. It's a little bit more nervous, I could say. It's a little bit also better for off-roading. And the big plus of this gearing for the Wilderness, you can tow up to 3,000 pounds, and if you don't have the Wilderness model, it's only 1,500 pounds. So that's a big plus for the Wilderness model. Interior wise, we've got the Wilderness treatment inside of here, so a lot of like yellowish bronze details, stitchings and all that. We got some good seats with the Wilderness stamp on the headdress. Plenty of space in the back. I can fit behind myself, so adult can fit easily back there. And also the seats are pretty comfortable. I like the shape of those seats. You know, sometimes when you step down to like smaller cars, you have to make some kind of sacrifice on the seat. You've got pretty decent seats. If we take a look at the trunk, big opening, can put some serious big, you know, box back there. Really practical, one of the best in the segment, big cargo area. The Forester always have, you know, everything to please pretty much everyone. You know, it's easy to drive, you got a great vision all around, the fuel economy is decent, it's one of the safest, you know, car on the market. You've got a bunch of technologies like the eyesight and all that. Plenty of space in the back, plenty of space in the trunk. So that's why, you know, when you see like the top three Best Buy in each segment, the Forester is always in that top three. And this is pretty much because it's checking all those boxes. Performance wise, we don't have any turbo engine inside of the Forester, not like the Outback. Obviously, in the Outback, the performance are way better. It's way much more powerful with the turbo. But this four-cylinder is not slow. It's pretty fun to drive. It's decent on the fuel economy side also. So nothing to complain there. I think, you know, if you're looking for more performance, more power, you have to step up to the Outback. And obviously, you know, offering maybe a more powerful Wilderness would compete or step on the Outback territory. That's probably why there's only one engine inside of the Forester. But, you know, so far today, it gets the job done. of course, it's a Subaru Evan. We're doing some off-roading today, and we're gonna try the X mode. So basically, in the X mode, you've got some off-road mode, I could say, snow, mud, and all that. We've been driving these Subaru Wilderness in really narrow little trail, you know, full of muds and snow and all that. The X mode, the symmetrical all-wheel drive works really well. We've got some all-terrain tires, good for all year round. They have the famous, you know, snowflake stamp on the tire, so they're still good here in Quebec during winter. Obviously, it's not a real winter tire. If you do a lot of city driving or you're driving a lot on the actual ice, you should definitely use a real winter tire. But all year round, you know, if you're in the country and all that, it's a pretty good tire. Off-road wise, it's good, but it's not like a real off-road tire. And you know, this is where you have to make kind of like a choice between are you going all the way off-road with some big treads? When you use some big tread, you have to make some sacrifice on the noise you're gonna produce on the highway and all that. I think this tire is really the sweet spot between like driving daily on the highway in the city all year round, and sometimes you do some off-roading, so you've got that extra grip. Obviously, it's not something like the DuraTrack I've got on my Yukon. It's still a mild all-terrain tire, I could say. Another cool feature with the Wilderness model, we've got a front camera, so if you do some off-roading and there is some obstacle in front of you, you can use your front camera. This is always practical. We don't have the big screen just like inside of the Outback, but everything is simple, easy to use. We've got a bunch of buttons. Once again, everything is like, you don't have to search to do something. Everything is really simple. One thing it's missing inside of this for us, or it's really a place to recharge your phone wirelessly. I think in 2022, all cars should have this feature, especially when you're in higher trim, like the Wilderness or the Premier.
All right, so now I changed model of Forester. I'm inside of a Premier model for the afternoon. So the Premier model is a top line trim in the Forester lineup. This one is mostly more luxurious, a little bit less off-road capable. There's less clearance in the front and the back, but we replace all the rugged and tough off-road stuff for a more luxurious finish. So we don't have the rugged bumper in the front and in the back. We've got some nice finish also around the windows. Also the roof rack, it's all in silver and all that. So all little touches all around. One of the main differences you're gonna notice for the Premier, other than the design outside, it's the interior. We have some really nice seat, all in brown and dark charcoal. Some nice stitching and all that. So that's one of the main difference here inside of this Premier. Once again, even if it's a top of the line trim, we don't have any wireless charging for my phone. Unfortunately, that's really something missing. Even if it's not the Wilderness model, it's still super capable. I'm driving in some gravel roads right now with some ice and some snow, but right now we've got some winter tires. It makes the difference. If you're looking to drive in the snow all the time and some ice, obviously some good winter tires makes the difference. The tires on the Wilderness does the job all year round. If you drive a lot on the ice and all that, you should consider some real winter tires. Ride wise, the Premier is more comfortable than the Wilderness. I think the shocks are mostly tuned for comfort, and also it's more smooth when you're driving the Premier because the gearing is not the same. So inside of the Premier, you've got a longer gearing, so it's going to be better on fuel economy, but you have to make a sacrifice on the towing capacity. So that's something you have to keep in mind if you're looking more for fuel economy or for towing. Different models inside of the Forester lineup can make a difference, especially when you're choosing the Wilderness model. Overall, to conclude my first drive with the 2022 Forester, really some nice, you know, redesign, refresh added to the Forester, some big improvement into the high sight model. You know, I didn't have any issues with the system today. Works really well and it has a lot of safety, so that's a big plus to keep in mind for this 2022 Forester model. So the Forester is really easy to drive, you know, easy to park. It's really capable off-road wise, especially the Wilderness model. Just with the off-road track I did today, it was pretty impressive for a car. You know, I don't like to compare cars with trucks, but you know, this trail we were on today was borderline made, you know, for trucks. You know, you wouldn't expect to see a car or a Subaru going through that trail, so it was pretty impressive. So is the Forester Wilderness my favorite Wilderness model? You know, I prefer a little bit more the Outback model. If you're cross shopping between those two models, I think the Outback, obviously, it's more expensive, it's bigger, it offers you more, you know, off-road capacity also with the multiple mode of the X mode. So that's a big plus. And you know, obviously, I'm a big guy, I prefer always bigger cars. But if you're looking for something smaller, like the Forester, but no sacrifice on the off-road capacity, but still fun to drive on a daily basis, I think it's a really cool package. So let me know in the comments, which trim level is your favorite for the Forester? Is it the Premier? Is it the Wilderness? Let me know. And we're gonna see each other on the next review.